We went out to dinner after the Saturday night service, and it was you and I and Doug and Jim Tomberlin. And he said, maybe you should think of yourselves as a neighborhood church, like the old parish model. When he said the phrase neighborhood church, something in my mind and heart clicked. I went, I like that. It just struck me. I even texted Brian on the way home. We both shared that. We both had a similar response to that. Talked about it with our senior management team. Similar favorable response. Something about that idea. Talked to our staff about it. Our executive council about it. Same idea. That there was all, people were moved by that. Yes. Now, this is still taking shape. So we're sharing with you the sort of the embryo of a vision, if you will. What I mean, what we think we mean by that is not multi-site where we're trying to put a video venue in every city in the Chicagoland area, but a strategic gospel-centered effort to reach our region where God's placed us, our neighborhoods. People live in neighborhoods. And one of the things that struck that was said to us, to me, by Jim Tomberlin, that struck with me is, do we really expect more and more people to drive from farther and farther away to a bigger and bigger box here? You drive through neighborhoods to get here. You pass by other people to drive to this church. Why? What if we began to think about multiplying who we are in different neighborhoods around the Fox Valley over time? I'm talking just down the road, right? If you ask the average person if they like, if they would prefer a church of 250 or 2,000, what do you think most people would say? 250. Feels better. But if you ask them what they would prefer from their church, they start talking about things that only a 2,000-person church can provide. In the neighborhood model, perhaps there's a way to do both. And I do not know yet, nor do we know what that will mean or when that will happen, but we think it's a good and the right time to talk about. We think this is where God is aiming us as a church, and we're willing to walk that path. Just as we never intended to be two campuses here, but we are, and God's done amazing things through that. I think perhaps this is another redirection for us as a church family.
Now, back to what I said when I was talking about before Jeff explained that process to you. We were reviewing Growing to Serve because originally we did plan on adding a lobby space there, some office space here. And so we keep looking at that. And as we do, what we want to let you know is that looking forward, what it means is we anticipate that this could mean we're moving in two directions at once over the near-term future. Meaning we are going to evaluate those plans for this West Campus. There are still a couple of things we would like to get at in this physical plant, this facility right here. For example, we have some nursery space issues. Not necessarily always on Sunday mornings, but midweek with our women's ministry, which is an area of ministry that's growing, and it's one of our major outreach engines. And we have had midweek problems. We've had to borrow other space to put babies in because our nurseries aren't large enough. So we have some nursery space issues here that we need to take care of. Because if you don't have room, adequate, attractive, safe room for people's children, you don't have room for them. And that's one of the first decisions people make. So we need to address that. We also would like to address this room a bit. This room was not intended to be a full-time, forever worship center. It's a multi-purpose room. And as we look ahead, if we're not going to build a big worship center out there, we would like to see this room become more able to facilitate powerful worship experiences than it is right now. So we have some issues to address in this room. And we have a question to answer about Shepherd's Heart Care Center. Our Shepherd's Heart ministry is growing dramatically. That's the ministry that we used to call our food pantry. Now it's Shepherd's Heart Care Center. It involves a lot more than just food. It's at the East Campus lower level. It's doubled and even tripled in size over the last few years, and God is trying to do something unique there. And so we're asking ourselves, what's the next step for Shepherd's Heart? Do we create new space out here for a freestanding other facility? Do we liberate office space and bring it over here so we can turn the entire lower level over there into Shepherd's Heart and let it grow? We don't know. Those are all questions we're asking. So we are anticipating that when we come back to you, maybe this August, in the annual meeting, maybe some other time, with here's our next Growing to Serve ministry expansion project, it won't look like what we thought we were going to tell you 2 years ago. It won't just look like here. It's going to look too prompt. It's going to say, we're going to do this at the West Campus at this amount for this reason, and we're going to do this preparing for our third campus, or have the third campus in sight or to rehab something or whatever, or we're going to be preparing for that. Does that make sense? We're going to likely be looking at two directions at once. Now, like Jeff said, we're not far enough down the road with the third campus idea yet to even know where it's going to be or what it's going to be. We just feel this really strong pull over the last 8 or 9 months to be paying attention, that God's trying to do something.
Before we started in this second site here at the West Campus, we were growing so rapidly at the East Campus that we started Valley Brook Baptist Church with Brian Smith. And we asked several members of the congregation to commit to go there for a period of time to help that get launched. And we did that because we didn't have room there and it was going to take a while for this to be able to get developed. Is that something that's also in a future plan, is to grow in some of these neighborhoods by doing something similar to that?
Great, great question. So church planting and multi-siting are similar but different things. And you're right, we planted a church. If I don't quite get the question, there's several parts to it, I'll try. National surveys show that 60% of church plants fail within the first 3 years. They don't make it. Over 80% of multi-sites succeed, thrive. Now, there are lots of different ways to do multi-site. Most of us think about like what we think of Harvest or Willow, where there's a big video screen and you just kind of plug and play. That's not what we're talking about, to be clear. We would see predominantly live preaching with leadership raised up in that neighborhood. So what makes a church multi-site is not whether or not there's a video venue, but how, if it's centrally governed, reproducing our DNA and having a central kind of governance and connection to the mission and vision and values. So when we say multi-site, that's what we mean. It's kind of a, to your point, Glenn, it's kind of a hybrid between the old church plant model and the other extreme of campuses.
As we consider expanding our influence outside of the city limits of Geneva, and also understanding that our culture has a pretty bad stereotype of the word Baptist, are we also considering a name change?
That's a great question, and I think yes, we would say we're open to that. I like the phrase neighborhood church. Envision neighborhood church at Peck Farms, neighborhood church at, you know, Pepper Valley, neighborhood church at wherever. So we don't have plans. We're not rolling out a new name or anything. But I think if God did this, and again, we're holding this loosely. We don't know when or if this will happen. But if God did this, it would be the natural right time to make such a change.
So what part of our, is there any percentage of our congregation that currently lives in that area?
For example, okay, that's the great next question. You're thinking right alongside with us. Our thinking right now, and we've actually visited, Jeff and I flew over to Ohio to visit with my brother's church leadership. They have four different sites along with our main one. They've done it all sorts of ways. A church was deeded to them. Then they bought property and built another one. They're looking to take over a theater. They've done it several ways. We went up to Minneapolis a couple weeks ago, visited with a church up there. We're trying to learn as much as we can from people who've done this. Our thinking is whatever facility, the hardest thing to find is the right place for our next campus. That's the biggest decision, where it is and whether there's a neighborhood there that can be reached. And we would make the decision based on where it is, what it would cost us to get it, if anything, what it would cost to make that site viable, where it is, how many of our people right now come from that neighborhood, and how many of them would be willing to go there and reach their neighbors. Now, it's possible that some people from the neighborhood would rather just stay here because they're not terribly entrepreneurial or evangelistic, or they don't see that as their calling. That's fine. But we would look for people for whom they go, who are excited. Yeah, that I live there. That'd be a great place. I could take people right down the street. And so we would, and in this particular neighborhood, we have tons of people who live there.
Do we have, and have we looked at or felt led to the staff that would further carry our DNA? That have we onboarded for people at this point within this culture, within this dynamic? Because as a member for many years and bringing children in, and throughout almost 20 years, I've brought 18 and again 2-year-olds. So I see the same faces in the nursery, in the senior children staff, and that stability has been critical. And you talk about sharing that DNA, and it's not just room in the nursery, it's faces, it's consistency, it's people that we feel good about, and God leads those people. Are we seeing those people to bring on?
That's first of all, I think you're very insightful in your comment that it's not just space, it's people that create the DNA. Of course, it's people. To your question about do we have a team assembled? No, not yet. But we would. I am of the opinion this is not something you hire outside for. This is if you want to reproduce who you are, it should be who you are. And so we are in the process right now of thinking about, well, who would that be? What would that look like? You know, and again, I don't, it's important we don't get hung up on this particular church and this particular, this may not happen, this the one that's approached us. But it has caused us to ask these questions and say, we think this is where God is directing us. And yes, we are in the process of not only identifying, but laying out paths for other people in our church to move into positions of leadership. One of the things that multi-siting can do is create opportunities for young leaders and leaders inside the body already. They would otherwise have opportunities to grow their leadership.
I was just curious with adding another campus, how you would address some of the student ministries that are building specific.
Typically, as we're learning, is these new sites start off with sort of a very lean model in terms of staffing and what they do on weekends. Is for example, it's worship, children's ministry on weekends, and that's it. It means the students would typically go in with their parents to worship. Now they would participate, and for example, Sunday evenings, they'd go to all their D groups, mix in with everybody else. All the campuses would be involved there. So some would be centralized, some would be local, and we'd have to depend on where the site is, how large it is when it starts, to know what to put on that campus for weekends.
Would Masterpiece in particular be something that we would try to provide for in each one of these sites?
That's a great. Masterpiece has quickly become a part of who we are. And so, yes, I think we would want to be special needs sensitive and strategic about that at any of our sites. Buddy Break and other things, again, we might represent those there. But yes, I think that's become part of our DNA, part of what we want to reproduce and who we are. And part of the reason people come from so far away to the church. And so we'd want to do that in other places as well.
So you kind of touched on this, and maybe it changed my question a little bit. Is the plan for the two of you to preach at all three campuses?
I think our assumption would be, with our third site, there would be a designated campus pastor who would be that pastor. He would preach there most of the time, but we would be free to rotate as we saw needed to make sure people felt and knew all of us. But there would be a main campus pastor that they went to, that was their go-to guy.